Kim Ye-suk is perhaps the longest-serving prisoner ever to escape from North Korea.
I went to the prison camp when I was only 13 years old, and I got out when I was 41.
The year was 1975. One morning, North Korean government agents burst into her home and dragged away all the members of her family.
My entire family went to prison. Some were taken to the mountains, others were put in different labor camps, all because of my grandfather's one mistake. He escaped to South Korea during the Korean War.
Kim and some of her family were sent to Re-Education Center No. 18, also known as Bukchang.
How many members of your family were killed in the labor camp?
Seven. I lost seven members, including my grandmother, mother, brother, and my husband.
Today, she wears dark glasses to conceal her identity.
I wear these glasses because I have family in the camp. Two of my sisters and brother are still in there.
Bukchang holds some 50,000 prisoners. It's one of six political prison camps operated by the North Korean government. Human rights groups estimate some 200,000 North Koreans are languishing behind the walls of these secret internment camps.
I attended indoctrination classes in the morning. In the afternoon, the children were sent to push trolleys in the coal mines, often without any safety gear.
Kim says she was forced to work 16 to 18 hour workdays with no rest.
People were dying in the mines. There were numerous mine collapses, so many injuries, people who lost their legs, many who were buried alive. It was horrible.
You were, in essence, treated like a slave.
Yes, I was treated like a slave, and worse. I hardly slept. It was inhuman. But I never complained. I just followed all the rules. I had to find a way to survive.
Prisoners didn't have enough food to eat. A family of seven was usually given just 10 pounds of corn a month.
1996 was horrible. That year, many people died of starvation. There was nothing to eat. There was no grass. No plants were growing. You looked around and there were bodies littered throughout the camp. At first I was shocked, but then you become numb to it all.
Were there days when you felt like perhaps this is not worth living, that perhaps you thought about killing yourself, that you wanted to commit suicide?
Yes, I thought of committing suicide hundreds of thousands of times in those 28 years. But the way the camp is set up, there's always someone watching you. Each prisoner is assigned to watch four or five other prisoners. So if anything happens, the other prisoners would alert the guards because they didn't want to get into trouble themselves.
You saw public executions. You saw people get killed inside the camp.
Yes, I witnessed countless public executions. And often these prisoners were killed over petty things like stealing food. The guards would always gather other prisoners to watch the execution. It was a form of intimidation.
Perhaps most chilling is Kim's account of fellow prisoners killing their own children to stave off hunger.
One time, a mother put her 9-year-old daughter in this big cast iron pot and boiled her. She was too big for the pot, so the mother had to chop her legs and head to feed the body in the pot. On another occasion, a lady killed her 16-year-old son, chopped him into pieces, and took him to a butcher shop to get some corn in exchange.
And this is uncomfortable for the world to hear.
It is hard to talk about, but I want the world to see these images and to hear my testimony.
This summer, Kim released her memoir called A Concentration Camp Retold in Tears. She describes in detail her escape from Bukchang and subsequent defection to South Korea in 2009. The book includes images drawn from memory of the horrors witnessed.
I'm thankful to be alive, but I can't get over the fact that I've lost half my life.
In September, she flew to Washington to testify before a United States congressional panel about the beatings, starvation, and brutal executions that she witnessed in Bukchang camp.
What is your message to the world about what is going on today in North Korea.
My message to the world is that we have to shut down these labor camps and set the prisoners free. Every day people are dying. Every day people are killing each other. I am living proof that there's no human rights in North Korea.
George Thomas, CBN News, Seoul.